I want to ask up our host, Katie. Will you please come up? Katie is the co-director of Runway, and you've launched with your partner the Female Founder School. You know, I scheduled an extended time, a little extra time, so you could talk about inclusion. You could talk about diversity in terms of tech, what you're actually working on, and I can't wait to hear what you have to share. So the first question that we had discussed was, what is possible in the next decade?
Sure. First of all, I want to say we're so excited to have you, Ian, as part of the Runway family. You are just exceptional. Can we give a round of applause to Ian for tonight's event? We really appreciate it. In the next 10 years, the Bay Area will be more prosperous.
Yeah.
And this will be because the technology industry will be leading the way in inclusion. We'll see more diverse executive teams. We'll see company practices and hiring practices that are more inclusive. And we'll see a broader breadth of needs met and problems solved. And this will lead to better financial results and more market opportunities.
And this is why we are starting the Female Founder School, because underrepresented founders are the source of this prosperity. From our experiences, when I first started as a founder who did not know what she was doing, I wasted a lot of time on ideas and spent a lot of money. And what I realized is that until I came to Runway and got the mentorship and support I needed, I was just spinning my wheels. And this is why we want to bring the framework, the mindset, the network to not only later stage founders who have the money and the support, financial support, but the really, really early stage, idea stage founders who will change this industry for the next decade.
That's right. And the Female Founder School is a 3-month long program to equip aspiring female founders with the tools and the connections to enable them to test their ideas and start companies.
And you have one going on right now.
That's right.
And Jackie Sino's a part of
That's
it.
That's right.
You know, we both think Jackie's a hero, right? We've
Absolutely.
Talked about how inspirational Absolutely. Jackie's been to us personally, and I'm so happy that she's connected with you.
We're lucky to have her, absolutely.
She's lucky to have you and vice versa. Now, you already have your first cohort launched, and you're going to be doing these regularly. So if there's a woman that's in the audience, if there's a woman that's watching online live or the archive, like, how can they get involved? What would make them qualify? What does it take to get in the club?
Sure. Well, first I would say that everyone should be part of this movement. Everyone has a role to play when it comes to supporting underrepresented founders. Whether you're a mentor, whether you're an executive, whether you're a student or an investor, we all have unique experiences, unique insights, talents, qualities, decision-making power that we can bring to bear on creating a more inclusive technology ecosystem.
Specifically, in terms of if you are interested in being a founder, whether or not you're ready to quit that daytime job, and by the way, we have plenty of founders in our program. It's actually designed for women who are actually working full-time, or if you're a mother who has multiple things to juggle, we want to bring that framework and all the support to you.
Yeah.
And so it is created with that in mind. And then the other thing that I touched a little bit upon earlier is that you're never too early, because a lot of the frameworks that's in place that we're familiar with, especially in Silicon Valley, it's really for founders who already have that MVP, who already have that traction. That's when you're getting the financial support and the accelerator support. People are giving you money. But in the early stages, no, it's just you. You're just by yourself. Or maybe you've finagled a friend to help you with this idea. But ultimately, we realize how important it is to really support the true early stage founders, because the pipeline problem cannot be solved if you're only supporting people who've already had the financial support to build that MVP,
That's
right?
Good.
And so from our perspective, if you're sitting home and you have an idea and want to be a founder, go on femalefounderschool.com and write to us, like, apply. We'd love to talk to you. And it really doesn't matter where your idea is, because we believe that the power of underrepresented founders is that they're saying, as Katie was saying earlier, they're seeing problems that aren't being seen before, and they're coming up with solutions that are not being addressed in Silicon Valley because we're such a homogenous place.
Anyone.
And the other thing is, if you don't necessarily see yourself as being a founder, I encourage you to use your financial power. We're seeing now more than ever that women are becoming more financially independent. And a lot of times, the money that you're spending doing your day job is just going to your savings account or checking account, and maybe you're investing it a little bit. But we want to encourage more women to see, and men as well, allies, to see the power of their money and how it can go towards supporting these early stage founders. Yeah. Because right now, 95% of venture capitalists and institutions are men. And so if you see the power in these underrepresented founders, go mentor them, go have a conversation with them, and even maybe invest a little of your savings with them.
That's great. Do it. What's your vision for the next decade? Not decade, for the next year. Like, what are you hoping happens? What's your vision for the Bay Area, for inclusion, for Runway's female founders, for other groups that are your peers that are doing similar things? Like, what do you want to see happen this year?
Put simply, I want to see people recognize their positions of influence and use those positions of influence to support underrepresented founders.
I would also not mind if there was more transparency in the investing industry, especially for where VCs are disclosing not only the companies that they're investing in, but also the representation of the founders that they're meeting with, that they're taking meetings with, because I think that kind of transparency is necessary for us to build a more inclusive community of founders, because those founders are the ones who will be creating the diverse solutions and the diverse community that we will hopefully see.
I love it.
Website again?
Femalefounderschool.com.
Yeah, femalefounderschool.com. And can you tell us about somebody that's in the school that you really see like, they're a great model. Like C. Simone is in the Female Founders School. We all love C. Simone. You know, she's amazing with what she's doing with Film Hero. Like, what is she doing that's helping all the other female founders? What's Female Founders doing for her? Like, give us a case study in terms of like what's logically happening in the accelerator.
Sure. So the way that we start is we teach very important entrepreneurial frameworks for how to test an idea so that if you're deciding, do I want to take this on full time? Can I make a business out of this? You can gain the evidence to prove that, so you're willing to take that step. And the next thing is you'll be connecting with other founders who are on that same journey that you're on, who can empathize with what you're going through, and who can provide feedback. We're also going to connect you to founders that are one step ahead, who have recently gone through what you've gone through and who have been successful.
And then additionally, we'll be connecting you with a larger network of supportive investors and mentors. And so all of this is to bring to fruit this entire cohesive community where Simone, in the case of Simone, she's not only a participant, but she's also mentoring other women in the same community.
Like? So there's so many powerful women that have been very, very successful. And what does it look like for somebody that has success, can advise, can mentor, can guide? What does it look like for them to get involved? And how would they get a hold of you to engage with you?
Sure.
Email us.
Yeah. Like give me a, look at the camera. Give me a promo video right now so I can send it to all the powerful women that I meet. And like, you should help Female Founders School.
Yeah. Well, help Female Founders School, because supporting female founders, your mentorship, your unique set of skills will make it possible for them to create successful companies and unique solutions.
Yeah, and you can reach us at katie@runway.is or
enhao@mentorkind.org.
And that's runway.is. Yes. Thank you so much for hosting us, for letting me be part of your family, letting me do these events. Love having you, nice selfie with you too.
Thank you.